press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello students, here. Good afternoon everybody. Sorry, good evening. Good evening to everybody. All of you are bounding in the four walls because due to the corona crisis, the school has not still been open. The online classes is going on. Here, who am I? You don't know. Don't you know? You don't know, yes, because I am your, I have to introduce myself. I am your new teacher. My name is Basuraj. I am going to take social science. Social science. The social science has four branches: history, political science, geography, economics. I am going to take history class. What is history, students? You have studied in 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th. Then what is history? Don't you know? Okay, I'll tell you. What is history? History is a systematic study of past events. What is history? History is a systematic study of past events. History is a systematic study of past events. History is a systematic study of past events. What is study? What to do we study? We have to study history. How do we study? A systematic study. What are the things have to be studied? We have to study past events. Past events. How do we study? Systematic. Okay. First, we need to know that history can be classified into three types. The first one is ancient history. The first one is ancient history. Next one is medieval history. Next one is modern history. Ancient history, medieval history, modern history. You have discussed in the 6th, 7th, 8th and 9th ancient history and medieval history. Next, in 10th standard, we are going to study modern Indian history and modern world history. History, geographical area. On the respect of geographical area, history can be classified into three types. One is local, next nation, next world. Local ancient history, local nation history, local world history. Ancient history, local ancient history, which refers nothing but Karnataka history, state history around what can we see around of us. Local nation history, ancient, which is our nation, India. Ancient Indian history. World, ancient world history. First, local history we have to study. Or first we have to study about the world history. Ancient world history, we can see Roman civilization. Students, listen to me. Ancient world history, Roman civilization, Greek civilization, American civilization, French civilization. These are all the civilization that can be covered in the ancient world history. Next one is ancient nation history, ancient Indian history. What are the things, what are the lessons can be covered in the ancient nation history? The first one is Harappa civilization, which was the first civilization of India. Harappa civilization. Harappa civilization was born on the Banks River of River Indus. The historians refer, this is the first civilization of India, Harappan Mohenjo-daro civilization. It was also called as, it can be called as Indus civilization because it was born on the banks of River Indus. And next one is Vedic culture. You may have heard the four Vedas. Which are the four Vedas? The first one is Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda, Atharvana Veda. These are all the Vedas which belong to next dynasty. Next culture is Vedic culture. Vedic culture. And next, North India was ruled by after the Vedic culture. There are several dynasties who ruled over the North India. Shungas, Kanvas, so many dynasties. Among them, famous empire ruled over North India. It was called as Maurya Empire. Maurya Empire. Chanakya. You may have heard the name Chanakya was the prime minister of Nanda dynasty. And he was insulted by Nanda dynasty. Chandra Dhanananda. And he started along with the his name Chandragupta Maurya. He was inspired. Chandragupta Maurya was inspired by Chanakya, Vishnushera, or Chanakya. And he founded the famous empire. It was called as Maurya Empire. Who started Maurya Empire? Chandragupta Maurya. After the Maurya, the North India was ruled by the capital city is Pataliputra. The capital city of Pataliputra, after that, Chandragupta Maurya, Ashoka, the great of Ashoka. Ashoka was the famous king of Maurya Empire. You may have heard the name of Ashoka. He was popularly known as religion of Ashoka. He spread his religion, Buddha religion, Bauddha religion, Buddhist all over the India. And after Mauryas, who came to India, who ruled over North India, Gupta's empire. Gupta's empire, the famous king of this empire is Samudragupta. Next one is Vardhana dynasty, who ruled over the North India. Ruled over the North India. Harshavardhana was the famous king of this dynasty. This is the North India. By the contemporary year, at the same time, in South India was ruled by. Who ruled? South India was ruled by localist, which means Karnataka, which means South India was ruled by Kadamba dynasty, which is the first dynasty of Karnataka. Kadamba dynasty is the first dynasty of Karnataka. You may have known that, which is the first inscription of Kannada. Almidi inscription is the first inscription of Kannada, which belongs to the this dynasty because this was carved by Kakutsavarma, who belongs to this dynasty. Name Kakutsavarma, the first inscription of Kadamba dynasty is Halmidi inscription. After the Kadamba, before that, this province was ruled by Shatavanas. Shatavanas. Next, Karnataka was ruled by Kadambas. Next, after Kadambas, who ruled over Karnataka? Gangas, nearby Mysore, around of Mysore areas, ruled by Karnataka. Gangas, the famous king of Ganga, Durvinita. You know that the statue of Bahubali, or Gomateshwara, which was carved by Chavundaraya, who belonged to this dynasty. Which dynasty? Ganga dynasty. And next, after Gangas, Chalukyas of Badami, who came to power, who ruled over Karnataka, their capital city, he was Badami. Students, did you go trip? You have seen. Did you go trip? You had seen Badami. There are a number of sculptures are there. There are four sculptures are there in Badami, which was carved by the Badami Chalukyas. After that, Kalyani dynasty, who came to power, Kalyani dynasty came to power, they ruled over the Karnataka. They also sculpted, there are a number of temples, Lakkundi, nearby Kuruvatti Basaveshwara, or that is not Basaveshwara, that is Mallikarjuna. And next one is Sangameshwara. These are all the places nearby us.
And next, after the Kalyan Jalaka dynasty, next South India was ruled by Rashtrakutas, the famous Kaviraja Marga, the poetess of which is the first poet of Karnataka, Kaviraja Marga, which is prepared by Sri Vijaya, was sheltered in the court of the famous Amoghavarsha Rupadunga. He was the famous king of Kalyanas of Chalukya dynasty. After that, you know that Vaisadas, who ruled over the Karnataka, the famous king of this dynasty, Vishnuvardhana. After Vaisada dynasty, one of the strongest. This is all ancient local history, ancient nation history, ancient world history. Next, when you come to the medieval history, all the Hindus rulers ruled entire ancient history. That is why in Indian history, ancient Indian history was also called as Hindus history. Next one is, we are going to discuss medieval Indian history. Medieval Indian history was ruled by one of the famous Muslim dynasties. The first, 1206. Before that, Muhammad Ghazni, who invaded 17 times, and he looted an enormous amount and jewelers from India to their country. And next, after that, and he demolished the temple of Somanatheshwara, temple of Gujarat. And next, after that, Muhammad Ghori, who came to power, the famous battle in 1191, battle of Tarain, which took place between Prithviraj Chauhan and next Muhammad Ghori. Muhammad Ghori was defeated by Prithviraj Chauhan. Next year, second Tarain battle, which took place between Muhammad Ghori and Prithviraj Chauhan. Prithviraj Chauhan was defeated by Muhammad Ghori and his disciple, his name. After that, he was killed by, means Prithviraj Chauhan was killed by, means his name, Muhammad Ghori. Muhammad Ghori, who started, his disciple, his name, Qutbuddin Aibak, he started Delhi dynasty, Sultanate dynasties. There are 5 dynasties. The first one is Slavery dynasty, Khilji dynasty, Tughlaq dynasty, Sayyid dynasty, Lodi dynasty. We have studied in 9th or 8th standard. 8th standard. Next, Qutbuddin Aibak, who started this dynasty. Next, Alauddin Khilji was the famous king of Khilji dynasty, Tughlaq dynasty. Muhammad bin Tughlaq was the famous king of this dynasty. And next, Sayyid Lodi. 1206 to 1526, during this year, was ruled by Delhi's Sultanate dynasty, 5 dynasties. After that, Babur, who invaded to India, was basically, originally from central part of India, central part of Asia. He invaded India and defeated the last Lodi dynasty, Ibrahim Lodi, and he founded the strongest empire, that is named Mughal Empire. Who started Mughal Empire? Babur. How did he start? By defeating of Ibrahim Lodi in first Panipat battle in the year of 1526. Next, Humayun came to power. Next, one of the strongest empire, his name Akbar was the famous king of Mughal Empire, and also he was popularly known as the great Ashoka. Like, he is also the great Akbar, because he was famous for his religious policy. He loved all the religions. He was non-tolerance. He did not hate any other religious. And Aurangzeb was the last king of this dynasty, most strongest last, and it was go ahead. And next one is Maratha Empire. This province was ruled by Maratha Empire, was founded by Shivaji. After Shivaji, Sahu, there are a number of Peshwas who came to power, but they were unable to compete against the British.
The next, this is the modern Indian history. Medieval Indian history. Next, when we come to the medieval Karnataka history, there are two dynasties nearby us. The first one is Vijayanagara dynasty. Next one is Bahamani. These are the two important dynasties are there in the medieval Karnataka history. When we come to the medieval world history, we have studied in the 9th standard. You know that the French Revolution, the Russian Revolution, the rise of Nazism and Hitler in the European country. You have studied. Next, you have also studied. Directly, we are going to, in 10th standard, we are going to modern European history, modern Indian history, modern European history, modern Indian history. This is world history, this is Indian history. Modern European history, which are the chapters are there? The first one is the section 1, events and process, the rise of nationalism in Europe. Rise of nationalism in Europe. And next one is, that is modern world history. Second one is modern Indian history, the rise of nationalism in India. The European nationalism was affected on Indian history. There are two chapters which are very relating. That's why you have to listen very carefully. The rise of nationalism in Europe, the rise of nationalism in India. And next, second one is livelihoods, economics and societies. The making of global world, the age of industrialization. These are two chapters only for test. The first one have introduced, first two chapters are very important. Second section only for test. Third one has been reduced due to the corona crisis. Okay, students, did you understand, guys? Okay, what we have to study? We have to study the modern Indian history as well as modern Indian history as well as modern European history in 10th standard. Okay, the rise of nationalism in Europe. Next, history is a systematic study of past events. I have forgotten. How do we study? A systematic study. What do we study? Past events. What are the past events? The people of ancient people, their lifestyle, their social system, economic system, political system. Next, the king. Who ruled over the king? And what are the battles which took place between kings? What are the contribution, art and architecture, inscriptions, literature? These are all the things we have to study in the history. That's why it is called as history is a systematic study of past events. Which history can be studied in 10th standard? Modern European history as well as modern Indian history. There are two chapters. Okay. What we have discussed, one is the meaning of history, the types of history, and next the brief introduction of history. Next, we are going to directly class the rise of nationalism in Europe. Next, tomorrow we shall discuss. Thank you for giving this opportunity. And next, students, I need your feedback. How class was there? How was going on? It get to energy, increase my energy. Thank you.